A lot of people often ask me, hey, Haishuo, what do you do for a living?
Playing sumo?
No, I'm too skinny for that.
A bodyguard?
No, I'm too fat for that. I'm a high school teacher. Though the very first day I got to my high school, I was stopped by the school guard because he thought I was a bad guy. Contest master, honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen. As a teacher, I often need to monitor the test. You may think it's boring standing there watching students for 50 minutes, but it's actually really interesting. Just imagine your students are all animals. And you are taking a trip in the zoo. There are students who are like lions. They are strong, they are fast, and they attack the test paper into pieces. There are also students who are like bears in the winter. They just don't know what to write. And of course, there are my favorite giraffe students who always stick their heads super long during the test. I always know the best way to find those giraffe students. Why? Because I was the best giraffe when I was in junior high school. According to my careful observation, there are three kinds of giraffe. The first kind, the professional giraffe. They are good, they are accurate, they are deadly, and they are quick. Their heads never move, their eyes are like tracking cameras. Sneaks! Sneaks! When a teacher have noticed, the job is already done. When you look at them, they are so calm. There's no way you can stop them. But I have devised a great strategy to stop my students from cheating. I just walk to him and his targets. I block them with my belly. That's why I never lose weight. This is for the education of Taiwan. And the second kind of giraffe is called the acting giraffe. They also use some actions to cover their intention, but inevitably draws attention. For example, they yawn and peep. They turn their heads and peep. And of course, they pretend to sleep and peek. Dealing with this kind of student is really easy. You just stare at them, they got scared, and the show is over. The last kind of giraffe is my favorite one. It's called the guilty giraffe. This kind of giraffe are often really good students. They don't plan to cheat, but there was this chance. They just can't fight temptation and decided to take the peep. But because they are so inexperienced and they are so unskilled, so when you look at them, they get scared and they freeze. Look back into you, their face showing, sorry, I did nothing wrong, please don't punish me. I always enjoy playing with this kind of student. It's like playing green light, red light. It's really interesting. You gotta try it if you become a teacher someday. One day I really couldn't help. I want to know why my students cheat in the test. So I get my students into the office. So I walk to the very first student, the expert giraffe. Hey, why do you peep at others' test paper? Well, teacher, I just do what the test paper said. I'm trying to find the answer. Now walk to the second student, the acting giraffe. Hey, why your answers are all the same with the girl sitting next to you? Oh, teacher, that's because the girl and I are meant for each other. Then I walk to the guilty giraffe, the student who isn't supposed to cheat. Son,
I wish I didn't see you cheat in the exam.
Teacher, I also wish you didn't see me.
Hearing all these reasons, but you know what? As an expert giraffe, when I was in junior high, I always know there's only one reason why students cheat. Why? Because they didn't prepare well enough, so they don't have confidence. That's the only reason that they cheat. Life is actually very much like this. There are times that we lose confidence in ourselves. We don't believe the decisions that we are making, and we decide to take a peep at others' life. But God gave us different life. Our lives all have questions with different answers. So what's the use peeping at others' answers? Especially, what if their answers are wrong? After years of experience, there is something that I can tell you confidently. That is, there's only one way to solve this problem, a three-step solution. We need to prepare well, do our very best, then have faith. Allow me to repeat, prepare well, do the very best, and have faith. So the first step is prepare well. Why do we need to prepare well? Because when we prepare well, we have the confidence in ourselves. What's the second step? We need to do our best. Why we need to do the very best in us? Because that's the only way that we can find pride in our work. And last is we need to have faith. Because when we have faith, we can move mountains. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, after 20 years of preparation and hard work, this is how a giraffe becomes a strong lion. Contest master.